Hey folks, welcome back to our channel. Remember our last blockbuster product, the BT20A Pro? Since its release, it has won the enthusiastic pursuit and countless praises from numerous audiophiles. We sincerely thank you all for your support and encouragement. Today, Fosi Audio is presenting another blockbuster new product, tailored to the needs of our fans and hi-fi enthusiasts, the V3 Mini Stereo Amplifier. It has many bright features, please follow me and have a close look at it. First of all, let's dive into the look and craftsmanship of the V3. One of the highlights of the V3 is its groundbreaking heat dissipation design. The top and bottom of the casing feature stylish circular vents that not only enhance the aesthetics but also effectively improve air circulation, allowing the internal heat to dissipate more efficiently. The V3 also incorporates a special internal heat dissipation design, which I will delve into in detail in the next section. The V3 boasts a minimalist design language, with a compact size that is similar to the palm of an adult hand. The outer casing is crafted using CNC aluminum alloy integration, with a finely sandblasted finish that provides an excellent tactile feel. The front panel is elegantly simple without any visible screws, featuring a large control knob. The knob serves as the power switch and volume control. The V3 comes standard with a black knob matching the body color, while an optional metallic orange knob is also available. On the left side of the knob, there is a power indicator light that illuminates in a fashionable blue color when the device is in operation. The rear panel houses the input and output interfaces, including a set of RCA line-in inputs, a set of speaker outputs, and a full-range pre-out output. In terms of power input, the V3 supports a range of 24 to 48 volts power supplies, with a standard 32 volts, 5A power supply that caters to the majority of bookshelf speakers. If you require higher power output to drive larger bookshelf or tower speakers, an optional 48 volts, 5A power supply is available. Next, I will disassemble the V3 to give you a glimpse of its internal design. After introducing the exterior design and input-output functions of the V3, let's now take a peek inside to see what the internals of the V3 look like. The V3 is an amplifier from audiophiles and for audiophiles. The inspiration for the V3 development comes from hi-fi enthusiasts who have a passion for high-quality audio. After listening to numerous suggestions and feedback from our fans and supporters, we have made significant upgrades to the internal components of the V3 compared to our previous products. First and foremost, the V3 features the high-end TPA3255 Class D amp chip, capable of delivering a maximum output power of 600 watts into two channels. This amp chip is highly regarded by users for its high power output, low noise, and low distortion characteristics. The V3 comes standard with the NE5532 socket op amps from Texas Instruments. They are swappable, allowing users to customize their sound preferences by rolling for other 8-pin dual op amps. I will demonstrate the steps of rolling later on. In addition to the high-quality amplifier and op amps, we have incorporated audiophile-grade capacitors in the V3. These include Japanese NCC filter capacitors, German WiMA high-frequency filter capacitors, and Japanese ILNA coupling capacitors. The inductors used are professional audio inductors from Japanese Sumida. The power input circuit employs soft start resistors, and we have also implemented a special energy-saving circuit design that allows for zero power consumption and true shutdown when the device is turned off. Additionally, the V3 features a logarithmic taper a pot that provides a more linear perception of volume adjustments, enhancing the auditory experience. Now, let's focus on the heat dissipation design mentioned in the previous section. For the first time, we positioned the amplifier chip underneath the circuit board, isolating it from the capacitors. This design helps prevent the risk of damaging surrounding capacitors due to chip overheating. Furthermore, the amplifier chip is covered with a nano-coated heatsink that tightly attaches to the casing, allowing the heat generated by the chip to be conducted throughout the entire body of the amplifier, effectively turning the entire casing into a heatsink. This groundbreaking heat dissipation design significantly enhances the cooling efficiency. With the addition of the audiophile-grade components and innovative heat dissipation design, the V3 is capable of working stably even under high power conditions. During normal music playback, there will be no automatic shutdown due to overheating or overload. After going over the exterior design and internals of the V3, I'd like to share the specs sheet here. Let's go through it quickly. It supports a maximum output power of 600 watts. The signal-to-noise and distortion ratio reaches 88 decibels. The signal-to-noise ratio is as high as 110 decibels. The noise floor is as low as 140 microvolts. It supports passive speakers with an impedance of 2 to 8 ohms, and a frequency response range of 20 Hz to 20 kHz. To date, the V3 is our best performing amplifier in terms of specs. We believe that it's also one of the best amplifiers in its price range. Next, let's move on to the product demonstration. The audio source being used here is an iPad, and the decoder is our DS1 USB dongle. Firstly, connect the DS1 to the iPad with a 3.5mm to RCA cable, and then connect it to the RCA terminals of the V3. Next, connect the V3 to the passive speakers. Ensure that the left and right channels are correctly connected, and do not reverse the positive and negative terminals. The V3's binding posts support both banana plugs and bare wires connection. You can choose the method you prefer. Finally, plug in the power adapter and then turn the knob clockwise to power on the amplifier. And play music on the iPad. Furthermore, the pre-out output terminal at the back of the V3 can be used to connect a powered subwoofer to set up a 2.1 system. Alternatively, it can be used to daisy chain another amplifier and connect additional speakers. You can also connect a subwoofer amplifier, such as our MO4, to drive a passive subwoofer. The V3 is an amplifier designed with audiophiles in mind. One of its standout features is its swappable op amps design. By using different op amps, you can achieve different sound characteristics, adding to the playability of this amplifier. If you have your own preferred op amps, you can follow the steps below to make the replacement. First, let's gather these three tools: an Allen wrench, a pair of needle nose pliers, and a pair of tweezers. Next, remove the knob from the front panel and use the needle nose pliers to remove the nuts and washers from the pot. Then, use the Allen wrench to remove the four screws on the rear panel and bottom. Carefully pull out the main board. Near the front panel, you will easily spot the two NE5532 op amps. They're 8-pin socket type. Now, use the tweezers to gently pry them up from the side and remove them. The next step is to install your own op amps. Pay special attention to the orientation of each amp. Notice the notch or the number 1 on the chip's surface cover, which should face a specific direction. Installing the chips in the wrong orientation could damage them. Please refer to the provided reference picture. Once the two new op amps are securely installed, you can test the sound by connecting the power and speaker cables. If everything sounds normal, proceed to reassemble the casing. With that, the complete process of replacing the op amps is finished. The entire procedure is straightforward. The V3 supports popular 8-pin dual op amps. We have compiled a list of known compatible op amps for the V3, which you can refer to. We have also recorded a demonstration video of the V3 using different op amps while playing music. The demonstrated op amps include Muses 02, OPA2604, JRC4580D, and the famous Sparco's SS3602. The video showcases their unique sound qualities and characteristics. Please watch the video linked below this one to find out which is your favorite. Alright, that wraps up our in-depth look at the V3 mini amplifier for today. If you're interested in this product or want to know more about its features and how to use it, feel free to drop us a comment below or send us a private message. We'll be more than happy to answer your questions. Thanks for tuning in, and please remember to hit the like button and subscribe to our channel. We've got a few more interesting new products coming up in the next several months. We'll be sharing the instructive and demonstration videos with you then. Please stay tuned.